even got a secret handshake, and she loves the music that my band makes. I know I'm young, but if I had to choose her or the sun, I'd be one nocturnal son of a gun.
Take a look at my girlfriend, she's the only one I got.
Well, come on and let me know, should I stay or should I go?
Binder review. This kind of binder. First, we're going to start with the one that everyone knows, and that's GC2B. This company has come under fire recently because apparently this isn't as good quality as it used to be. This is the one I bought within the past 6 months. I have one from a couple years ago that actually took my nipples off. I'm going to factor in two things when rating these binders: the cost and how it feels and or fits. GC2B is pricey. It will run you back like $50 for one binder. It feels tight. It's securing everything. Everything is pretty flat. I love that about it. It's hard to get on and off, and it can feel hard to breathe if you wear it for like 6 hours. You're supposed to be able to get 8 to 10 hours a day out of a binder. This one I wouldn't really wear for that long. On a scale from 0 to 5, I give GC2B a 2.5, maybe a 3. Next brand. This next one isn't a binder. It's actually a crop top. It's from a brand called The Girlfriend Collective. It's marketed for women. But if you cannot wear a binder and you want something that is still pretty tight and feels like a binder, this I recommend. It kind of looks like a sports bra on me because I got a size slightly too small, but it's meant to be a crop top. It doesn't flatten my chest as much as the GC2B binder, but it flattens it enough that I can wear baggy t-shirts and tank tops. I can sleep in it and wear it for multiple days without having to worry about anything happening to my nips. Plus, it's a little bit cheaper than GC2B. These are like 30 bucks. There's different kinds that have different types of straps too. Considering it's not technically a binder brand, but it's pretty good for support to help when you can't wear a binder, I give Girlfriend Collective a 3.5 out of 5. Number 3 is also technically not a binder. This is a Nike sports bra. I think this is the Nike Pro. I always get these in a size too small. This is a good alternative for kids that have parents that you can't ask them for a binder because they won't buy you one or you're closeted. Ask them to buy you a sports bra. Just make sure to switch out the size that's right for you with one too small in the changing room. I used to switch the hangers. You know, clip the small onto the medium hanger so my mom thought she was buying me the medium. This fits nice. As I've washed it, this has loosened up a bit. It still fits comfortably, but it's not as tight on the chest as it used to be. It's clearly a sports bra. I couldn't wear any tight clothing with this because you would see my nyeh. I give this a 2.5 out of 5. Now we're down to the bread and butter. Tomboy X. This is actually a binder. I think it cost me like $40 or $50. It fits really comfortable. It's made really well. Not to mention, I've slept in this. I rate this a 5 out of 5.
Dear transmasculine folks, this is including myself, so don't feel like you're being singled out, because honestly, I don't think that anybody can be singled out at this point. You are no longer allowed to pick any of the names on this list, because I know at least 3 of each. It is getting harder and harder to keep track of you motherfuckers. By the way, half of these came from my Snapchat and or my TikTok. I have to start putting last initials on y'all to differentiate. Everyone's Bitmoji looks the same. Don't blame me. CJ, AJ, Damien, Kai, Zephyr, Roman, Rowan, DJ, Elliot, Elio, Xander, Cade, Caden, Oliver, Ollie, Eli, River, Ryder, Ezra, Mars, Aiden, Arlo, and any planet name. Kenny slash Kenneth is also on this list because I see y'all motherfuckers. Sincerely, short-term memory loss.
It's subtle, but it's there. I'm an old man.
Welcome to the part 2 that nobody asked for. I'm gonna give myself a mustache and maybe some wrinkles. I don't know, we'll see how it goes.
I only own drugstore makeup. Do not judge me. Men have bushy eyebrows. I shaved half of mine off, so I gotta fix that. I tried. For mustaches, you're supposed to, like, right? I feel like I did something wrong. Can't tell if I made it better or worse. Okay, so I gave myself sideburns and a goatee, and now I'm gonna, like, contour, maybe? I don't know. I gave myself a beard. I changed my outfit. I don't think you guys are ready for this. Dramatic reveal. Are you guys seeing this shit? I'm, like, properly old. That's crazy. I genuinely don't know what to do with myself. I could be your fucking English teacher. And what then? I take being old very seriously. Vintage. It's not actually. I got it at TJ Maxx. Now time to find out if it's Victor approved. Victor?
Monkey covering eyes emoji.
I've been binding daily for 3 years. If you didn't know, I'm trans and I have parts of my body that are not equivalent to what I want to look like. And I actually have top surgery scheduled. If you want to donate to my top surgery fund, the link is in my bio. But I have been consistently chest binding for 3 years. So I have a bunch of different kinds of binders and I'm going to try them all on today and see which one works best because I actually got sent a free binder today. I haven't opened it yet. It's from Wannababy. We're gonna review that binder, but first I'm gonna go through the ones I already have. This first binder is actually a DIY binder that I made for myself when I was like 15. If you can't buy a binder or you don't have a way to order one, I bought a shapewear from Target and then cut off the bottom piece, and then I wear this and then just fold it against itself again, like that. And this works really well, especially if I have tops that I don't wanna have straps on or something like that. This really does work. It gives me a tiny little bump up top, and then also because it doesn't have straps, I have to like pull it and adjust it, and especially at work, like that's very noticeable. So I don't know, like it's, yeah. And I have an old GC2B binder. I don't recommend these anymore because I've heard that GC2B has gone kind of downhill with their quality, but I got this right at the beginning of quarantine and I really like this binder. So in terms of passing, this does a very good job. However, it is so hot and it's really uncomfortable and very tight. So I can't wear this for more than like 3 hours. So I'd say like a 7 maybe, because it works, but not long term. Like if I wear this to work, I can't go anywhere else that day. Lastly, I have a Spectrum binder. This one passes really well, but it's even more uncomfortable than the one I was just wearing. It goes down even lower, and it also, it just feels like a tarp. Like it's not comfortable. This is what the inside of it looks like. It is really, I know that binders have to feel this way, but it's so uncomfortable. Okay, I have high hopes for this binder because all of mine are kind of mid right now. Already, super cute packaging, absolutely love it. Really adorable. Let's see what it looks like inside. Oh, I didn't realize I got the skin color one. I don't have any skin color ones, so that's kind of nice. Looks really good right up the front, the racer back in the back. Let's try it on. Okay, I'm trying on the straps and it is very tight. I got a medium, but I think I should have gotten maybe a large. However, it works really well. And it's also comfortable. It's tight. Again, I think I might not be able to wear this one because of the size for more than a few hours, but it's comfortable, not scratchy on the inside. And I think if I got the right size, I'm sure I'd wear this a lot more. So yeah, great job. Wannababy, go get their binders if you want a binder.
Hi, my name is Dan. I'm trans, I'm exhausted, and I'm an F cup. Let's talk about it. When you are FTM and you are itty bitty titty committee, you don't really need to worry about binding quite so much, but if you are big bongo, you gotta worry about a lot. So let me tell you how I've been doing this for 10 years. I wear one binder brand and it is Underworks. I will not live for Underworks slander. Underworks is amazing. F cup. Underworks. You can't bind like you're itty bitty if you're a big bongo. If you have massive tits, you absolutely do not want to wear a half binder. You want the full binder. This one in particular is the 997 Ultimate Chest Binder. Brand new, old as ball. Underworks gets a bad reputation for being uncomfortable because they come not broken in and they're stiff and starchy. You can literally hear it. It's bad. Brand new, old as balls. I don't know if you can actually hear the difference that well, but the oldest balls one is really, really, really soft and very comfy. So this is brand new out of the package. This is the brand new one that I just bought. I wouldn't recommend putting it on directly out of the packaging, like I just did. I mean, you can, obviously, like, this fits, this works. It wasn't that hard. It was a little, I'm used to it. I've been doing this for 10 years, but, it's a little tougher than, like, a Jeezy Doobie, but, you know, this also binds, like, 10 times better. Like, I'm an F cup. This is the worst part. This right here. When you have a bigger chest, I recommend getting the full length one because you're not just putting all the constriction right here in the center. That's going to give you the barrel chest. Whereas if you have like the tautness pulling you down as well, then it's going to pull you flat, not just crossways, but like downways as well. It's going to keep you in place really, really well. I never need to fucking adjust these things, especially when they fit right. There is no stiff panel. Like, this thing is entirely made out of something called power net, which is extremely breathable. It's a wide tooth, so as you go through your day, it's actually going to kind of mold to your skin. And it honestly, it doesn't make you hot. It doesn't make me sweat. It's like it's not even there. It's amazing. So if you want to give it a shot, I recommend buying one in your correct size. I'm an F. This is a medium. A medium, because I'm kind of skinny, but I'm also big-chested, therefore binding. Anyway, wash it like 2 or 3 times first, and then only put it on when you're fully dry. Go get him, Tiger.
I know something you don't know.
Hi, I'm Asa, and this is me 1 week on T.
I'm Asa, and this is me 1 month on T.
Hi, I'm Asa, and this is me 2 months on T.
Hey, I'm Asa, and this is me 3 months on T.
Hey, I'm Adonis, and this is me 4 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 5 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 6 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 7 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 8 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 9 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 10 months on T.
Hey, I'm Adonis, and this is me 11 months on T.
Hi, I'm Adonis, and this is me 1 year on T.
Bitch, I wake up, no status. Fresh as fuck, I put it on all up, I did this shit. Got it fine, hold no makeup, and she's still an edit shit. She in school, but it's cool, yeah, I still my baby.
L excuses, right hand on the Bible. God can strike me down if I'm lying. That motherfuckers!
Wow, I need a minute to think about this.
I'm gonna rip you apart. I want to apologize.
Trying so hard every night and day, and now we get to pay back. Trying so hard, saving up the paper, now we get to lay back. Working so hard every night and day, and now we get to pay back.
Bitch with combos like it's Tekken. Only thing that I lean is your bitch when I bend her over. Sipping Poland Spring in Arizona. Fuck a Coca-Cola. That's your Juliet.
Talk about the tall femme to short mass pipeline. When I was little, everyone was like, oh my god, you're so tall. Like, growing up, everyone was like, oh my god, you're so tall. And now I'm a short king?
Hi, my name's Jace. I'm sick right now, but this is 1 day on T.
I'm 1 month on T. 2 months on T.
3 months on T.
I'm 4 months on T.
5 months on T.
6 months on T. 7 months on T.
This is my voice. 8 months on T.
9 months on T.
It's 10 months on T.
It's 11 months on T. One more month, motherfucker!
I think this is where I was. Hi, my name's Jace, and this is my voice. 1 year on T.
Switching sides.
You're talking about Strikor, but he's not here. Are you fucking...